I'm out of London, in Buckinghamshire, in the Chilterns, in the North Chilterns, and I'm going to go over a couple of majestic hills, Pitstone Hill to Ivinghoe Beacon, following the ancient trackway of the Ridgeway, for part of the way at least. I'm very excited about this walk. There's a few burial mounds here, a hill fort. Yeah, really looking forward to it. It's going to be a great day out over the hills. Almost inevitably, the way I want to go is cracked and laying on the ground. It's got to be a metaphor, isn't it? Lights coming through the trees on the Ridgeway is so beautiful. I grew up in the South Chilterns near High Wycombe and walked around there, as I've mentioned before. So we wouldn't really come up this way because we had the Chilterns on our doorstep, literally outside the front door. So, I've never actually been up here. I mean, Ivinghoe Beacon is a famous place. It's the start of the Ridgeway, or the end, I suppose, depending on which way you go. But I've been up to Tring once, I think. I've got the train too, so new territory for me. We've already got some fantastic views from this pathway, looking back across fields towards more hills. Morning. So this is where I am, in the middle here, entering Ashridge, Aubrey Nowers Nature Reserve. You know, if you watch a few of these videos, my relationship with maps. And the acorn is the symbol of the Ridgeway. So this is where the ascent of the hill really begins. We've been gently going up, and now we go up through this wood. The Ordnance Survey map shows a couple of tumuli next to the path, near the edge of the woodland at the foot of Pitstone Hill. I wonder if this is one of them here, and that could be the other one next to it. I'm not 100% sure, but it seems to fit the location. I'd say that was a possibility. I took a trip out to a burial mound over in East Hertfordshire about a year ago, actually. And it was very similar to this one. If this is indeed a tumulus, there's been archaeological remains from the Neolithic right the way through to the Roman period found around Pitstone Hill, so this could date from any time within that, I suppose, if it is indeed a burial mound. Wow, look at that light over there. Today I've seen quite a few people already this morning. I've only been walking about half an hour, and it confirms what I said in my book, This Other London, that when you walk open spaces in London, sometimes you don't see a soul the entire time. You might see one dog walker or perhaps a runner. Sometimes you can go for hours walking across open spaces in London and not see a soul, whereas to come out into the Chilterns, you're tripping over somebody every couple of yards, and that has been the case, even though it's a Friday morning, you know. Lord knows what it's like at the weekend. The Ridgeway is the oldest prehistoric track in the country. And I've seen it written in a few places that some people believe it dates back to the time when Britain was connected to Europe via a land bridge. And it was this track that brought the first people into Britain. Consider that for a moment when you're going for your Friday morning stroll. Wow, getting some incredible views now. Fantastic, gnarly old beech tree. So fed up with going the wrong direction, I've gone and bought a compass. Because there was a little part of me thought, I could be going the wrong way, even though that's almost impossible. It's happened on a few walks recently. So this confirms that I'm going the right way. So here, the Ridgeway follows Grimm's Ditch, which is said to be an Iron Age defensive work or possibly a boundary marker between tribal regions. And it runs for about 40 kilometres from Knapp Hill in Buckinghamshire to Dunstable in Bedfordshire. You can really see the chalk breaking through here. The Chilterns is chalk and flint. If you break the ground anywhere around near where I grew up, that's what would come up. Chalk and flint, and they use the flint in the houses there. This is just majestic. So I think these are the old flint mines. Like I say, they go back, well, I don't know, I mean, it could go back to the Neolithic. They found Stone Age implements here, all the way through up to the Roman period. And that hawthorn tree in the middle, hawthorn being an important plant in pagan belief. Here we go. Here's some flint in the bottom of the pit. A nice lump of chalk here as well. Stung by a stinger now, getting that out, that's my commitment. Lovely bit of flint here, all around in the grass. There's evidence of occupation on Pitstone Hill. It goes from the Neolithic age right the way through to the Roman, and it seems that the chalk pits were in use throughout that period. And excavations have shown that there was a causeway enclosure along the edge of the hill here that is again dated to the Neolithic period. The archaeological report I read talks of the top of this hill. It describes it as a citadel. I suppose this is like the Neolithic citadel, crisscrossed with a number of hollow ways and causeway ditches. I'm not sure if this is part of the Neolithic causeway enclosure or part of Grimm's Ditch. I think it may be Grimm's Ditch. I think that is Ivinghoe Beacon in the distance there. Some places where you walk, where you're told or you've read that there's ancient trackways and old earthworks, you really have to use your imagination to conjure it up, to conjure up the distant past. But walking here, you feel like you're in it. You feel like you stepped back into the Neolithic, the Bronze Age, the Iron Age. It really brings you close to the distant past of England. It's wonderful. It's really quite hot now. The sun's fully out, midday. This is a good view looking back to Pitstone Hill. Glorious late summer's day, end of September. Perfect day to be out on the Ridgeway. Wow, that's a really steep gully falling away from this path here. It's quite steep now. Heading towards Ivinghoe Beacon. So this is a great view of one of the holloways winding its way through the valley. I'm not sure if that is part of the Grimm's Ditch or if that's a different old trackway. Helpful warning, letting you know there might be some unexploded ordnance lying around on the top of the hill. There's a view to make the heart sing. So many walkers out here today, but it's really noticeable that nobody seems to stop or take their time. Everyone seems to be racing to get to the top of Ivinghoe Beacon. It's a real shame. I mean, maybe they do the walk all the time, so they're used to it, but interesting. For the record, my pace today is about a mile an hour. It really is slow walking. Looking now into Ivinghoe Beacon. And Beacon Hill is one of the oldest hill forts in England. There's a number of burial mounds up there as well. It's one of the most significant places in the entire British Isles. A real nodal point. So that hill there must be the tumulus on the map just before Beacon Hill. So this is a really significant point. It's the point at which the Icknield Way crosses the Ridgeway. And I believe the Icknield Way runs from here across to East Anglia and to the sea. I think that's the belief that the whole thing joined together and crossed over the land bridge and right across Europe. And that is where the first people came to Britain from. Across Europe, across the land bridge, down through East Anglia and all the way down across England to the southwest, Avebury. All the way along the route of the Ridgeway and the Icknield Way are ancient sites, hill forts, burial mounds, places of worship, places of settlement, all the way along it. tells the story of southern Britain. Too many beautiful views. You could develop Stendhal syndrome out here. This is the last approach up to the top of Ivinghoe Beacon, Beacon Hill. So you can start here at Ivinghoe Beacon, and this is the Ridgeway down through Buckinghamshire, Risborough, near my old neck of the woods where I grew up, across the River Thames at Goring and Streatley, and down through the North Wessex Downs to Avebury and Overton Hill in Wiltshire. First planned to do the Ridgeway when I was backpacking in Southeast Asia. When was that? 1994. So when I get home, I'm going to walk that with my dad. And we still haven't done it 22 years later. The old man's 81 now, so I think it might be a little bit of a push for him. It's incredible to think that all of this is less than an hour from London. It's amazing, isn't it? The train journey from Euston to Tring takes a maximum of 45 minutes. And then you got this. So I think I might follow this little section of the Icknield Way and go down to Ivinghoe Common. There's another tumulus down here somewhere. There you go. Whether I'll find that or not, I don't know. Getting here was fairly easy. This may test my map reading skills slightly more. So that way is Gallows Hill, and there's another burial mound there, which I think you can see. Changed my plan instantly. I couldn't resist walking along the ridge of the hill towards Gallows Hill rather than do that short section of the Ridgeway. So I'll walk along to the end of this ridge to the other tumulus, the burial mound, and then come back round, loop back round, eventually find my way back to Tring. So you can see that tumulus there, a lot clearer at the end. I think this is called Gallows Hill. Get a nice feeling when I see the crest of Buckinghamshire County Council. County of my birth and my childhood. The old two paths dichotomy. When in doubt, stay to the left. One of the topographical writers that I have drawn on over the years is a guy called SPB Mays. You know, really quite a establishment public school type figure. Broadcast on the BBC, very popular in the 30s through the 50s. Quite an eccentric guy in a way. Penniless his entire life. I extrapolated various principles that he wrote about with walking. He came up with the wonderful phrase to go solitary, slow and wayward. And I use that as my credo, solitary, slow and wayward. I'll put a link below to those principles that I wrote up on my blog. He talks about walking in the manner in people such as Richard Jefferies walked. Alone, walking the ancient ways. And through that, connecting yourself amongst the kind of hurdy-gurdy of the marketplace, as he said, with the distant past. This is where I am. I am here by Clipper Down Cottage. And so I'm going to actually follow this path here down towards Duncombe Farm, and then I'm not sure then, see how I feel. I might then detour into the woods to have a look at this tumulus either here or the one further along, if I can see it, the one deeper into the woods. I've eventually got to end up over here at Tring station. Like a blues man, I'm back at the crossroads, but this time I'm going to follow this footpath here, which goes around the boundary of the Ashridge estate and hopefully takes me towards the tumulus in the wood. But who knows, given that I am totally map illiterate. And that's the direction that I'm walking in, towards that farm and onwards. Funny, you get a sense when you're moving towards the end of a walk. We've got a couple of hours daylight left, but it looks like we're in the last section now. Not entirely sure where I'm going. Where's the rest of the fence gone? Did they even build it? So this path leads in the direction of the tumuli in the wood. Slightly lost my bearings, but I'm just going to go up here, see if I can see a burial mound. One interpretation of the map would have it up here somewhere, or one of them anyway. Other way I see maps as being open to interpretation. Oh wow, yeah. We could be looking at a burial mound here. There is supposed to be two in this wood, roughly where we are now. The thing that makes me think it might be is the presence of this ditch here running along, or a hollow way, and the very steep incline, but I could be completely wrong. So this is the top of that steep slope, and this does have the feel like it could be, like I say, a burial mound, a tumulus. And the path running along that ditch has the look of a hollow way. Let's see if it takes me to the other burial mound. Okay, this is a really
deep ditch running along here, like a hollow way or some sort of the edge of a fortification or a boundary ditch. And there's this path running along the top. So you can see, look, there's a really steep fall down. But the way this rises here to this bank in the middle and then drops away again into that steep gully and then up again, this sort of formation feels very deliberate. So you can see why they used flint for tools. I've just picked this up off the floor here. Look, and it's an almost perfectly formed implement. I mean, there's a possibility that has been napped, I suppose. We could just as easily have naturally broken away. Early evening now. This is a great time to be out in the woods. I nearly gave up on the walk back there and headed back in the direction of Tring. I'm glad I didn't. So there you go, confirms my suspicions. It says here, people have been walking here since prehistoric times. Below this bridge is one of the many ancient pathways that crisscross Ash Ridge. People lived at the bottom of the hill, herded their animals up here to feed on grass and acorns, wearing the deep sunken way we see today. This is the bridge they're referencing. With my newfound compass skills, I'd say that was the tumulus back there, or one of the collections of tumuli. See if I can find the other one. I'm not 100% sure I'm going the right way or exactly where it is in relation to here. But that's really exciting. I'm really happy about that. Wow, this was unexpected. This is the Bridgewater Monument in honour of Francis III, Duke of Bridgewater, father of inland navigation, 1832. So that must relate to the Grand Union Canal, which runs not far from here. And I'm guessing this is the other tumulus, the other burial mound. It's marked on the map as being near the monument, which is just there through the trees, and adjacent to the visitor centre, which is there, right beside the path. And this must be it. I wonder who's buried in there. What stories they could tell. People talk about trying to get off the beaten track. Well, this has been on the beaten track for thousands of years. You can't get more on the beaten track than this. But it's absolutely majestic. Well, this is an absolutely fantastic sunken path, a hollow way. And I've just fashioned myself a Gandalf staff from a fallen branch. How cute is this little village? Basically Trumpton, isn't it? Look at that, the post office there, the church bells are just ringing. It's called Aldbury, this village. That smell wafting out of the pub, that is manna from heaven.